contemplating the manner of pain worship leader here at St. Mary's in Parliament. I'm very pleased to have you with us. This is my first time ever reading the vows. So I'm going to do it now so I don't forget. And I'm going to try really hard to get it right. I publish the vows of marriage between William Barker Child of this parish with a following connection with St. Peter Torso and Injured Man Fleming of this parish with a following connection with St. Peter Torso. This is for the third time of asking. If any of you know cause or just impediment why these two persons should not be joined together in holy matrimony, you are to declare it. This is for the third time of asking. I publish the vows of marriage between Benjamin Brunt of this parish with a qualifying connection with St. Luke and St. Andrew's Bristol, and Eleanor Shaw of this parish with a qualifying connection with St. Luke and St. Andrew's Bristol. If any of you know cause or just impediment why these two persons should not be joined together in holy matrimony, you are to declare it. This is for the second time of asking. Let's pray for these two persons. Father, we pray for William, Injun, Benjamin, and Eleanor as they prepare for their weddings. We thank you for their desire to be married in church and ask that you will bless their married life. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You should have two pieces of paper, the order of service, and on a separate sheet, the psalm, and then you'll have the notice sheet which includes the collect for today. So from our order of service. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
This is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
We have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that by the power of the Holy Spirit we may give ourselves to the service of God. Jesus says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand. So let us turn away from our sin and turn to Christ, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Lord God,
we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and confess. Have mercy on us. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew our spirit in us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image to the praise and glory of his name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed is the Lord.
The Lord has heard the voice of our prayer.
Therefore shall our hearts dance for joy.
And in our song will we praise our God.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, creator and redeemer of all. To you be glory and praise forever. From blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray in one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever.
Amen.
The psalm we're going to read is Psalm 139, verse extracts. I will read the verses in bold print, and you can respond with the verses in normal print, and then we'll say the Gloria together at the end. O Lord, you have searched me and known me.
You know my sit down. When I utter, you discern my thoughts from far away.
You search out my path and my own down, and are acquainted with all my ways.
Even before the words of my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely.
You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me.
Such a knowledge is too wonderful for me.
Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence?
If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in shelter, you are there.
If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea,
even there your hand shall be, and your right hand shall hold me fast.
If I say, surely the darkness shall come in, and the light around me become light.
Search me, O God, and measure my heart. Test me, and know my thoughts.
See if there is any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
First reading is from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 12 to 22. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, where we cry, Abba, Father. It is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if, in fact, we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay, and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 13. He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds amongst wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came to him and said, "Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." The slaves said to him, "Do you want us to go and gather them?" But he replied, "No, for in gathering the weeds you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at harvest time I will tell the reapers, 'Collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burnt, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" Then he left the crowds and went into the house, and his disciples approached him, saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burnt up with fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where they will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father." Let anyone with ears listen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. Our next hymn is number 249, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Thank you. say together the Benedictus, just in your order of service, on page 4. Blessed
be the Lord God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born in the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised to hold, to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all the faithless, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the hope of us all to our Father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. And you shall the Lord profit in the most high. For you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins, in the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break on us, to shine on those who are in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet peace. The glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Please be seated. Mistake number one, I left the microphone on mute, where you couldn't hear me at the beginning of that bit. We now come to the bit where it says, a sermon is preached. Well, the good news is, I'm not allowed to preach a sermon, but I am allowed to do a talk. And so what I'm going to do today is share a few reflections on today's passage from Matthew. And then I will read again so that you can think about it again. And then finally, we'll have a moment of quiet to reflect on the parable using a contemplation written by Judith Dunn. But I want to begin with a morning prayer from the Celtic tradition. And it comes in the first person, so perhaps we can think of this as each of us. God to enfold me, God to surround me, God in my speaking, God in my thinking, God in my sleeping, God in my waking, God in my watching, God in my hoping, God in my life, God in my lips, God in my soul, God in my heart, God in my sufficing, God in my slumber, God in my ever-living soul, God in my eternity. Amen. I have to say, my heart dropped when I saw the reading for today. Not an easy parable, I thought. The parable commonly known as the wheat and tares comes straight after the parable of the sower, which we heard last week. The sower prepares the ground and sows good seed. All is well. But in the night, along comes the enemy who sows weeds, and not just any weeds. When they were young, these weeds looked like wheat. The Bible calls them tares. I wonder what motivated the enemy. Why did he want to destroy the sower's work? Envy is one of the seven deadly sins. It's more than jealousy or covetousness, as it has the added element of
destroy whatever it is that someone else has that you want.
Not just material possessions. Envy can seek to destroy relationships and success at work or school. Let us each be vigilant and refuse to allow envy to take root in our lives and in our church. There's often something theatrical about the stories Jesus told, and I love drama. I can visualise the glee with which the baddie sends his servants out at night to sow the wheat seeds and destroy the neighbour's harvest. You can almost hear the audience booing through melodrama. The seeds germinate to start to grow, and all looks fine to start with. However, as the plants mature, they reveal their true nature. Unlike us. Consider for a moment the reaction of the farmer. How would you react if you were in his shoes? He's very calm. Doesn't seek vengeance or justice. He's prepared to wait patiently in the knowledge that he can sort things out at harvest time. How patient are we? The parable ends with the harvest, when everything is resolved, the weeds are destroyed, and the harvest gathered. In Galatians 5:19-23, Paul includes envy in his list of the works of the flesh, and patience in the list of the fruit of the Spirit. Let us all pray that the gift of patience will grow in our lives and at St. Mary's. Listen again to the parable and Jesus' explanation of its meaning. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field, but while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat, and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slave of the householder came and said to him, "Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." The slave said to him, "Then do you want us to go and gather them?" But he replied, "No, for in gathering the weeds you would uproot the weeds along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at harvest time I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burnt, but gather the weeds into my barn." His disciples approached him, saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up in fire, so will it be at the end of this age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let everyone with ears listen." Finally, a moment of quiet to reflect on the parable using a contemplation. Contemplate how you react when your best plans are spoiled by another's care. patient enough to leave the outcome to God? What is more, contemplate the divisions within our churches and between our churches, the sects that proliferate and the sub-tendency we have to accuse the other of not honouring the truth. In the light of this parable, would it not be wise to let both grow together till the heart? Lord, I long to shine in your kingdom, and not to be fooled by the tempter. As all people grow together in one field, may I live as if I am the wheat, and not try to smother the wheat. For who am I to judge another? So we stand to say the creed on page 5 of your book.
Thank you.
gifts given to the church through other means. We pray that you will bless and multiply them. In your name, we pray.
Amen.
We sit on the hill for our prayers and intercession. Strength to all who trust in you. And because through the weakness of our mortal nature, we can do no good without you, empower us to work for your freedom and peace. With all your church, we pray for all who are longing and yearning for freedom. Lord, look in mercy on all who are struggling in life. Strengthen all who are being persecuted for their faith. Guide us as we seek to grow in our faith, that we may be led by the Spirit to become children of God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are caught up in corruption and decay. Forgive us where we destroy and mar the world through greed. We pray for areas where forests are being destroyed, the soil eroded, the water polluted. Guide by your Spirit all who groan for a better world, all who seek to restore and renew the earth. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We come with our own inner longings and hopes, that your glory may be revealed in our homes and in our lives, that we may know that we are all children of God and treat each other with respect. We pray for all who live in poor and slum housing, for those who have no home. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, look in mercy on all who find life futile. All who are bored, all whose work is unrewarding or dull, all who feel they have wasted their lives, all who are surrounded by decay and decadence. We pray for all who are struggling through sickness and disability, and we remember all those that are listed on our prayer list. All who are ruined by caring for others, may they know that the sufferings of this present time are nothing to be compared with the glory which will be revealed to us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We rejoice in your salvation, that you call us to be sons and daughters of God, that you call us out of death into life which is eternal. We pray for our loved ones departed, all those known to us, and also pray for Benny Calne Pickett and Desmond Paypal, who are on our list. And we also pray for a vision of your glorious kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Generous God, you give us gifts and make them grow. Though our faith is small and mustard seed, make it grow to your glory and the flourishing of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us.
Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you very much for being with us this morning. Do stay for coffee, which we serve afterwards. Our final hymn is number 503, O Jesus, I Am God's.
Fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all. Amen.
peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.